Okay, we're now going to look at parallel systems and feedback systems. So how does the parallel interconnection affect controllability and observability? So in the parallel interconnection, remember now, the system, each system, subsystem, receives the same input. The two outputs add together to form the overall output. So here's the state model for the two states, two subsystems. They all receive the same input. The output is the sum of the outputs. So here we have this overall state model. We've seen this before. And so now we're going to look and see how this system is affected, either controllability or observability. So we can go through and show that the parallel interconnection loses controllability if and only if A1 and A2 have a common eigenvalue, and the left eigenvectors associated with the same eigenvalue of both A1 and V1. So I would have W1 and W2 would be left eigenvectors of A1 and A2. They must satisfy these relationships. So this is the eigenvector relationship for A1. Here's the eigenvector relationship for A2. And then I need to have this relationship also satisfied. So if that's the case, I can go through and show that the eigenvector, that W1, the vector W1, W2, left eigenvector, times the overall A matrix is an eigenvector of that overall A matrix. And that W times the overall B matrix is equal to zero. So it's pretty straightforward. And that's because, again, it's diagonal. So if I take that vector, multiply on the left, I can easily see I'm going to get an eigenvector relationship here because it's block diagonal. And the two B matrices are just lined up there. So I'm going to get that eigenvector times W1, B1, W2, B2. And so it's pretty straightforward to see. Similarly with observability, the parallel interconnection loses observability if and only if A1 and A2, again, have a common eigenvalue, and some right eigenvectors, V1 and V2, associated with that eigenvalue of that common eigenvalue of A1, A2, satisfies this relationship. Okay, so we have that. So it's the parallel interconnection is the easiest one to analyze because it's pretty obvious how it all comes together. We don't have to show invariant zeros. In fact, we're not looking at invariant zeros here. But the thing that's different here, so instead of having invariant zero that matches with an invariant pole, with a pole, we have that the two subsystems have common eigenvalues. And so basically what's happening is, and the reason you have a problem with controllability, for example, is you're trying to control the same eigenvalue in two different systems. You're trying to get a different result applying the same input. Okay, and so you can understand that that's probably not going to work. Okay, so if you were, again, if the system's in diagonal form, you can see how that would come about. Similarly, for observability, is you have the eigenvalues of two systems doing the same thing, and you're looking at them from the output and trying to discern one from the other. And basically what this is saying is, in these conditions, you cannot do that. So notice it's not the same as observability and the original systems losing controllability or observability. It's that there's also a direction that's associated with it, so that these things match up. So it's possible for both A1 and A2 to have common eigenvalues, but if this condition is not satisfied, then the system is still observable. So we have that situation. What about now a feedback interconnection? So in this case, I'm going to assume that both D1 and D2 are zero. That makes the whole thing a whole lot simpler. Remember, when D1 and D2 are non-zero, then we have to worry about things like, well-posedness and so forth. So by setting this, we are ignoring the well-posedness issue, or rather we can discard with it. It's not an issue. But the closed-loop state model is given here. The closed-loop state model is given here. Now notice that in the feedback interconnection, we have a system going through and then feeding back. Okay, and so you actually have a series interconnection in that loop. You have one going this way and you have one going this way. And so you actually have two possibilities. Okay, so in this case, we have a similar set of connections as with a series interconnected system. And in this case, it can work both ways. So in this case, again, here I'm going to assume non-zero D1 and D2. And so again, these are state equations for the two sets of states. These are the output equations for the two outputs. And so remember, when we have this feedback interconnection, we basically can define these matrices, A0, B0, C0, D0, J0, I0. Yeah, it gets complicated. So diagonal A's, diagonal B's, diagonal C's, diagonal D's. And then you have these two guys. And again, defining the state variable is this. Defining now the output as Y1 and Y2. We can go through and show the system equations become this. Okay, so notice that in this process, we've actually defined the output as having two outputs. And so again, this is the kind of thing that you run into when you work with that feedback interconnection. So it becomes a complicated thing. So notice my A matrix has that A0, but it also has all of this other stuff going on. It also has this quantity inverse. So the well-posedness condition basically requires that this matrix be invertible. And we've seen that kind of thing before. So again, basically, well-posedness says that the determinant of that matrix must be zero, which is the same as the determinant of this matrix, non-zero. We can go through and show that the matrix J0 squared is minus I, and that J0 inverse is minus J0. And so this quantity, I can take J0 inside this inverse this way. And we can also show that since J0 inverse is equal to minus J0, we can show that this quantity is equal to minus J0 plus D0 inverse. Okay, so in particular, this matrix here, which has a J0 on the outside, can be simplified down to this. Actually, that should be J0. And so I can think of this as being A0 minus B0 times K0. So this would be K0. Or A0 minus L0 C0. And so we have these, and these are kind of like constraints. So we can look at this as if it were a state feedback type matrix or an observer type matrix. We'll talk about state feedback and observers later. But that's what it looks like when we do this. So how would we check for stability of this system? First of all, well, using Lyapunov theory, if we can find a P0 such that the closed loop matrix, so this is the closed loop ACL, so if we can find a P0 that satisfies positive definite, that satisfies this this linear matrix inequality, then our system is stable. Okay, what about controllability? So because of the form of this, controllability is not destroyed using state or static output feedback. So this is controllable if and only if A0, B0 is controllable. And this is true if and only if, since A0 and B0 are given by this, if and only if A1 and B1 are controllable. Okay. I'm sorry. So since A0 and B0 are given by these matrices, the diagonal structure requires that we would have to have both A1, B1, and A2, B2 being controllable. Similarly, for observability, we would have this restriction. So observability is not destroyed using static output feedback. So this is observable if and only if A0 and C0 is observable. So because we have this quantity here, A0, C0, so A0, C0 is observable if and only if A1, C1 is observable and A2, C2 is unobservable, or observable. So we need both of those to be observable. Okay, so if both of our systems are both minimal, then we have all of this. And so this is basically the diagram we're looking at this case. Okay, so that is, I have two inputs now. So instead of just one input, I have two inputs, two outputs. So both of the systems, in a sense, are receiving their own control signal, and both of the systems' outputs are being measured. And what we have just gone through and shown is that you get no net cancellations. Okay? You have no pole zero cancellations when you take the system with these two inputs and those two outputs. You cannot get cancellations because, in a sense, I can control these states using this input. I can control these states using this input, even though there's a feedback loop going on here. Okay. Similarly, I can observe these states through this output, and I can observe these states through this output, even though, again, we have a feedback loop going on here. So we have shown this the system defined this way has no pole zero cancellations, you cannot lose minimality. However, if we now restrict our attention to this input with one input and one output, we can go through and show that cancellations can occur. And now I've actually shown, we can actually show this, and this is one form of a feedback system. Another form of the feedback system would have these two in series and then a unity feedback kind of configuration going. And we can analyze that similarly. So here I'm not going to do the analysis, but we've gone through and shown how that kind of thing can happen. So for example, how can cancellations occur? So for example, controllability. How is it possible that we could lose controllability? So here's the input. This input needs to go through this system to get to this system. So if there is a zero here associated with a pole here, and if the directions match up, we can lose controllability. That is, I cannot control the states of this system using the input because of the zeros of this system. Similarly, for observability, I can lose observability, that is, of the system, because this system must go through this system in order to get to the overall output. So if this system has a pole that matches with a zero of this system, then I cannot observe that state of this system from the output. So we can get cancellations. So we've seen now series, parallel, and feedback interconnections. Stay tuned for the practice problems.